नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो महद्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपपौरोहित प्रज्ञानघन प्रत्यक्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभूम वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्र पराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महांतं गोविंद योगींद्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्री शंकराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तंतोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरून् संततमानतोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिप्राणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम् ओके सो गुड क्वेश्चन इज वेर वी पश्वादिभिश्च विशेषात् सो वी आर लुकिंग एट दैट टीका पश्वादिभिश्च विशेषात्
एवमिति इज वेयर वी
स्टार्ट एवमिति राइट इन द टीका एवमिति व्याख्यान
यस
ओके एवमिति शास्त्री यदा अध्यास व्यवहार तदा शिष्यत्व देहादि हम प्रत्यय एवमिति तल्लट स्पष्टम होता है ना हम सदेह उदाहरित लक्षणम यथा स्पष्टम है तदा उदाहरित सदेह नो नॉट दिस मच उदाहरित ही अन्यथा क्या त्यंगी करो चे सदेह या एवं एवं अध्यासे और एवं इति बिफोर दिस ओके यथा प्रत्यक्ष अध्यासे प्रमाण तथा आगमो पीछेर था नॉट इवन हियर बिफोर तर ही कथम वैदिक कर्मण हा ननु लौकिक व्यवहार से अध्यासकार्यत्वेन उक्तं पुरस्तात् दिस मच वी हैव नॉट सीन दिस आई थिंक वी वर हियर सो पश्वादिभिः च अविशेषात् एंड देन सामग्री सत्वात् या हियर सो तेषां वी हैड लुक्ड एट द कंक्लूजन देयरफॉर बिकॉज सामग्री इज देयर व्हाट इज द सामग्री हियर अध्यास सामग्री सो व्हाट एवर इज नीडेड फॉर अध्यास दैट इज देयर बिटवीन अ विवेकी एंड एन अविवेकी ऑल्सो पश्वादी सो राग द्वेष इज देयर इन पश्वादी They have basic understanding of Atmanatma, Samviveka is there. But still, they don't know Atma the way a human being can know Atma. Therefore, there is a difference in Viveki, all right, in any human being and specifically a Viveki. So, the Viveka itself was questioned as to whether it is knowing oneself as Brahma or Paroksha Jnana. As to Atma being separately, being separate from the Sharira, Shariradi. So in the latter case, where it is a Paroksha Jnana, there Aparoksha Brahma cannot go by Paroksha Jnana. This is where we were. So Aparoksha Brahma needs Aparoksha Jnana to counter. Paroksha Jnana cannot counter Aparoksha Jnana, therefore latter cases set aside as to there can't be an objection between for commonality between a viveki who knows atma is different from sharira parokshataya and pashu ityadi. Whereas if you look at a jnani, brahmajnani, their badhita anuvritti is there. Adhyasa is accepted by badhita anuvritti, so it cannot fructify. And I had mentioned bharjita bija, I didn't complete that, so we looked at other details. But bharjita bija example is given in the shastra to explain what is this badhita anuvritti of adhyasa or ajnana. Ajnana lesha is accepted because prarabdha is there. You cannot have prarabdha as karya without some karana lingering on. So that lingering on avidya, which does not affect the jnani at all, it keeps the prarabdha taking, that is called as avidya lesha. Similarly, there is adhyasa, which is a karya of avidya, that is adhyasa lesha. Now, this is badhita anuvritti because the jnani does not have any effect of it. There is no vikshepa, there is no avarna, although there is vikshepa. Vikshepa is not taken as real because avarna is not there. The atma shines forth even in vyavahara. So that is badhita anuvritti. What is bharjita bijavat? Like the roasted seeds. Roasted seeds are good for eating, not to germinate. They cannot bring about any sapling, any sprouting, and thereby you cannot have a sapling or you cannot have a plant or a tree. It cannot grow into a full blown tree. It can't even sprout. Similarly, the exemplified avidya, which is badhita, adhyasa, which is badhita, anuruti is there, but then it is for bhogaya, natu samsaraya. It will give bhoga. That is the prarabdha bhoga, but there is no samsarana. So that is something that I wanted to conclude. So the Puropakshi had asked as to, you know, just making such statements is not going to help me understand. You give me tarka. You put it in a vyapti, linga, paramarsha, that kind of language. Then we can make, then, you know, then there is some discussion possible. And then we saw all the hetus given there. Now he says what you are talking about. So adhyasa karyatvena tulya samana, what is samanyam there? Adhyasa karyatvena tulya, between pashu and viveki also there is tulyatvam, as adhyasa karya is there. They know right from wrong, and there is pravritti nivritti. Now the Puropakshi asks, nanu अस्माकं प्रवृत्ति अध्यासादिति न पश्वादयो ब्रुवन्ति नापि परेषामि तत् प्रत्यक्षम्. The comparison you are making between a viveki and pashu in vyavahara. Vyavahara is adhyasa karya. Because there is vyavahara, adhyasa has to be accepted. Now this is what you are saying, and thereby you are drawing conclusions. But then how do you know that there is adhyasa for pashus? They don't say it. No pashu says that I have adhyasa. But then the nyaya applies there. Vyavahara is there. We have shown you the vyapti. Wherever there is vyavahara, anumana has also been shown, and arthapatti also. So vyavahara is there. By arthapatti pramana, anyatha anupapatya, adhyasa has to be accepted. And anvaya vyatireka has also been shown. That is anumana pramana. And since this vyapti has been established now, and you have anumana and arthapatti pramana other than pratyaksha, therefore in pashu's case also you have to accept adhyasa. So asmakam, nanu asmakam pravritti adhyasa, this pravritti which is there, it is due to adhyasa, that is not stated by any pashu. Iti na pashvadeha bruvanti napi pareshami tat pratyaksham. And you cannot see adhyasa of others, let alone pashu's adhyasa. So how do you know? अतः साध्य विकलो दृष्टांत इति न इत्याह. Therefore there is साध्य विकल इन द दृष्टांत एंड द दार्ष्टांतिका. साधना एंड साध्य बोथ शुड बी देयर. यू कैनॉट हैव साधना एज कॉमन एंड साध्य एज डिफरेंट, और यू कैनॉट हैव साध्य एज कॉमन एंड साधना एज डिफरेंट. both should be there in the drishtanta as well as darshtantika. Then only it is a drishtanta and you can extend it to the exemplified darshtantika. Atah sadhya vikaraha, there is vyabhichara. There Bhagavan Bhashyakara said pashvadi naam chaiti. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara says पश्वादीनां च प्रसिद्धः ही सेड इट इज वेल नोन अविवेक पूर्वक प्रत्यक्षादि व्यवहारः दे हैव बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ डिफरेंस बिटवीन आत्मा एंड अनात्मा मीनिंग दे नो सेंशिएंट फ्रॉम इनसेंशिएंट दैट्स ऑल दे नो बट दे स्टिल हैव नो अदर विवेक बिकॉज दे नो ओनली बेसिक डिफरेंस दे हैव प्रवृत्ति एंड निवृत्ति दैट मच इज द कॉमनैलिटी वेयर बाय अध्यास हैज बीन शोन बट अविवेक पूर्वक प्रत्यक्षादि व्यवहार दे डोंट डिस्क्रिमिनेट एंड थिंक इन टू इट फर्दर वॉट इज द दोष इन अ मनुष्य कॉमन अक्रॉस द बोर्ड इज अविवेक दैट इज वाई विवेक इज द फर्स्ट मेक और ब्रेक ऑफ अ साधक साधक कैन बी अ साधक ओनली वेन ही स्टार्ट ऑफ विथ विवेक वैराग्य में भी देर बट वैराग्य डज नॉट मेक अ पर्सन अ साधक अनलेस इट इज ड्रिवन बाय विवेक देयरफॉर देयर इज कॉमनैलिटी दिस अविवेक पूर्वत्वम इज देयर इवन इन पशु व्यवहार व्यवहार हैज अविवेक प्रीसीडिंग सो प्रत्यक्षादि व्यवहार इज देयर दैट मच यू आर ऑल्सो एक्सेप्टिंग नोबडी कैन डिनाय पशु हैव प्रत्यक्षादि व्यवहार एंड प्रसिद्ध अविवेक पूर्वक दे डोंट नो राइट फ्रॉम रॉन्ग देयर फॉर दैट इज शोइंग अज्ञान एंड देयर बाय अध्यास व्याख्यान जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट प्लीज सो तेषां पश्वादीनां चेति देयर इज अविवेकपूर्वक व्यवहार विच इज प्रसिद्ध तेषां आत्मनात्मनोः ज्ञानमात्रमस्ति देयर इज ओनली ज्ञानमात्र व्हाट इज इट ओनली अ लिटिल ज्ञान ऑफ डिफरेंशिएटिंग आत्मा एंड अनात्मा नॉट सेल्फ फ्रॉम दिस शरीर दैट इज नॉट द मीनिंग हियर हियर सेंशिएंट फ्रॉम इनसेंशिएंट दे नो आत्मा एंड दे नो अनात्मा How they know objects, they know living things, they know non-living things. So, Atma and Atma Viveka, that much they have. Subject-object knowledge they have, somewhat. Na Vivekaha, not the discriminative knowledge. They have the faculty of Jnana, but they don't know how to utilize it completely. It is the faculty, the Antakkarana Buddhi is not refined. So they know, but they do not know that they know. There is no meta-knowledge and there is no inquiry possible. Upadesha bhavat, because there is no teaching. Even in human beings, although the faculty is there, although a human being can learn, have discriminative understanding of Atma and Anatma complete, Aikya complete with Brahma, but still lacking Upadesha, even a human being cannot know. There is no stumbling upon self-knowledge. Unless there is, of course, there is a trigger from the earlier Janma being Kalyanakrit. So in Purva Janma, there was Upadesha. We have to infer that. And in the case of Prani, anyway, Upadesha is not possible. So Upadesha Bhavat Viveka Bhava. And Viveka Bhavat Adhyasaha. Vyavahara shows Adhyasa. अतः सामग्री सत्वाद अध्यासः तेषां प्रसिद्ध इत्यर्थः सिंस दिस सामग्री इज कॉमन इन पशुस केस आल्सो दिस सामग्री इज अवेलेबल अविवेक दैट इटसेल्फ लीड्स टू अध्यास निगमयति तत् सामान्येति नाउ भगवान भाष्यकर कंक्लूड्स डज निगमन बाय सेइंग तत् सामान्य दर्शनात् व्युत्पत्ति मतामपि पुरुषाणां प्रत्यक्षादि व्यवहारः तत्कालः समान इति निश्चीयते. Therefore, there is सामान्य the व्यवहार that we see due to that and सामग्री being there, the अध्यासः is common between पशु and even व्युत्पन्न चित्त. सामान्य दर्शनात् सो व्युत्पत्ति मताम अपि पुरुषाणाम दोज वार विवेकीज इवन दे हैव प्रत्यक्षादि व्यवहार एंड ड्यूरिंग द प्रत्यक्षादि व्यवहार सो तत्काल इज तस्य काल इव कालः यस्य तस्य कालस्य इव काल यस्य प्रत्यक्षादि व्यवहारस्य समानः and that is samanah kala. So kala is in samanadikaranyam with samanah tatkala. And what is tatkala? Tatkala is vyavahara. Pratyakshadi vyavahara is tatkala. So this kala is samana between the is not kala, the tatkala samanah pratyakshadi vyavahara is samana, which is tatkala. And what is tatkala? Tasya kalasya kala iva. So tasya kalasya kala iva kalayasya. So that which has the kala which is common like the kalasya iva kalahayasya. See, this is like, you know, gajamukha samasa. Gajasya mukham iva mukham yasya. That is gajamukha. It will become gajamukha mukha and then one mukha, that pada will be dropped and you will get Gajamukha. Similarly here, Tasya Kala Seva. Or in those who have studied Vyakarana Sutra, you have Hraswa Dirga Pluta. There, Ukala is used. So, Ukala Hraswa Dirga Plutaha. So, Ukala, there is U and U. एकमात्रिका उकार देन उकार विच इज द्विमात्रिका एंड प्लुता इज त्रिमात्रिका एंड इट इज कंपेयर्ड विद द कुक्कुटस सो द रूस्टर यूजेस दिस ह्रस्व दीर्घ प्लुता इन इट्स मॉर्निंग कॉल वेर इट येल्स आउट कुकुडु कू देर दैट उकार विच इज देर इट इज ह्रस्व दीर्घ एंड प्लुता And Hraswa Dirgha Pluta is what? These are sanyas. Sanyas given to whatever has the kala comparable to the kala of ukara. That ukara. Not ukara, u. And u is a samasa. Not a samasa, u is bahuvachana there. So, u and u, all three will become dirgha u. By savarna dirgha sandhi. Pluta and any Ukara or Ukara will also become Ukara. Any combination of Ukara, Ukara and Ukara will become Jirgha. And that's Ukalasya Kala Iva Kala. Yasya. That will become Ukala. Ukala. And Ukala is what? That is Hraswa Dirgha and Pluta. Similarly here, the Kala which is comparable, Tatkala. We'll see in the Vyakhyana. Samana iti nishchiyate. There is a nishchaya done that there is samanyam between the Pashu and Adhyasa. Adhyasa samanyam between Pashu and Vivek is also. So samana. Samana iti. Tat samana. Tat samanyi iti. Taihi pashvadibhi samanyam vyavaharavattvam. तस्य दर्शना विवेकिनामपि अयम व्यवहार समान इति निश्चयति इति संबंध द कंसेप्ट इन द भाष्य इज सो व्हाट इज समान तैहि पश्वादिभिः सामान्यं व्यवहारवत्वं पश्वादि इज आल्सो हैव व्यवहार दिस इज सामान्य तस्य दर्शनात् व्हाई सो बिकॉज़ व्यवहार इज सीन देयरफॉर व्यवहारवत्वं इज देयर एटलीस्ट दैट मच यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट टू बिगिन विद दैट They have Vyavahara. Pashus have Vyavahara. So they have Vyavaharavattvam. Tasya darshanat. vivekinamapi ayam vyavahara samana. This vyavahara that you see in pashus, that vyavahara is there in vivekis also. Even vivekis have vyavahara, not only ajnanis, vivekis have vyavahara, that is samana. Iti nischiyate iti sambandha. This is the commonality now. Samanatvam vyavaharasya adhyasa karyatvena iti uktam purastat. And we have said earlier through, we have stated and concluded also through pratyaksha, anumana and arthapatti pramana that vyavahara cannot be without adhyasa, which has already been stated earlier. That is also samana now, because vyavahara is samanya, therefore adhyasa is also samana between the two. तत्र उक्त अन्वय व्यतिरेको स्मारयति. अन्वय व्यतिरेक हैज बीन मेंशन्ड, अनुमान प्रमाण हैज बीन शोन. यत्र अध्यास तत्र व्यवहार, यत्र अध्यासाभाव तत्र मीनिंग व्यतिरेक इज ऑल्सो शोन देर, व्यवहार अभाव इज ऑल्सो देर. सो देर इज, दे गो हैंड इन हैंड, दे गो टुगेदर. And this is a niyata vyapti, it works both ways. So we say wherever there is vyavahara, there is adhyasa. And when in Sushupti vyavahara is not seen, adhyasa is also not there. Other way round, also true, which is better way to look at it, adhyasa is not there in Sushupti kala. Vyavahara is not seen. In Jagrat avastha, adhyasa is there, vyavahara is seen. Niyata vyapti. Tat kala iti, this is reminded by भगवान भाष्यकर बाय सेइंग तत्काल. एंड व्हाट इज तत्काल? तस्य कालस्यैव कालो यस्य स तत्काल. दैट इज द समास, बहुव्रीहि समास. व्हाट इज तस्य कालस्यैव काल? सो तस्य काल एव काल, तस्य काल एव काल. दिस शुड बी अंडरस्टूड, कालस्यैव काल अध्यासस्य. तस्य कस्य अध्यासस्य? बिकॉज द अध्यास ऑफ द प्राणी, दैट काल इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द अध्यास काल ऑफ द विवेकी. So kalasyeva kala. Although in gajamukha samasa people generally say gajasya mukham iva yasya, gajasya, gajasya iva mukham yasya. People say gajasya iva mukham yasya. Now gajasya iva mukham yasya, gajasya iva means the entire gaja. The mukha is not like the entire elephant. The only the mukha of the elephant is common with the mukha of Ganesha. So comparison should be appropriate. If you say gajasya iva, by bringing anuvritti of, by daily deepanyaya or samnyaya, you bring the anuvritti of the mukha and make the vritti complete, samasa vritti. Otherwise it's a shortcut method to say gajasya iva mukham yasya. What it really means is gajasya mukham iva mukham yasya. Here also kala eva kalaha. Instead of iva, it is eva in the samasa. But tasya kasya adhyasasya, adhyasasya kalaha eva kalaha yasya satat kala. And these are different across pashu and adhyasa kala is different. But then adhyasa is different, kala is different. But if you take adhyasa kala as a, as something that you understand, whenever there is adhyasa, there is a, some time, that time is considered adhyasa kala. Now this time is different, adhyasa is different, but adhyasa kala is same. Meaning, adhyasa kala meaning does not change. That is there in pashus also and in vivekis also. Yada adhyasa tada vyavahara tada bhave shushuptav tada bhavaha iti ukta anvayadi maan iti yavat. This Anvaya Vyatireka has been shown. Anvayadi means Anvaya Vyatireka. That kind of Anumana has been shown earlier. Wherever there is a Adhyasa, Yada. Here Tatkala has been mentioned. So when there is Adhyasa, that is Tatkala, Adhyasa Kala, Adhyasa, Yada Adhyasa, Tada Vyavaharaha, Tadabhave. Tadabhave is Adhyasa Bhave. Shushupto, in deep sleep state, tadabhava is adhyasabhava. Iti ukte anvayadi maan iti yavat. That tatkala is shown to be having adhyasa. At that time there is adhyasa, because vyavahara is seen. So this anvaya vyatireka, which has been shown, smarayati, just makes you remember. Ataha vyavahara lingad vivekinamapi dehadishu aham mamabhimanaha asti iti anavadyam. Nirdushtam ichyartha. Anavadyam means there is no dosha. The dosha that you are pointing out by nanunacha, that isn't there. Why? Because vyavahari linga, vyavahara lingad, this vyavahara being there, that itself linga for paramarsha. So vyapti linga paramarsha takes place. You have anvaya vyatireka possible, that vyapti shows that, right? Yatra tra dhumaha tatra tatra vannihi. So vyapti is there. And dhuma is the linga. Dhuma indicates that there has to be vanni, although vanni is not pratyaksha. Ayam parvataha vanniman. Dhumat. Dhumavatvat. So dhuma is pratyaksha. Dhuma becomes linga. And then what kind of dhuma? Paramarsha is? This dhuma is what? It is having that vyapti. Therefore, dhuma is vyapya. Kena vyapya, kasya vyapya va? It is vanni vyapya dhuma. So, vanni vyapya dhumavan ayam parvataha. This parvata is vanni vyapya dhumavan, not just dhumavan. Because vyapti is recalled. So, here smarayati also has that connotation. It will trigger, when you are studying this, it will trigger that there is some vyapti in this linga. So, vyavahara is the linga, which shows what? Yatra yatra vyavahara, tatra tatra adhyasaha. Vanni sthaniya adhyasa, dhuma sthaniya vyavahara. So vyavahara has this vyapti now. It is vyapya vyavahara. Adhyasa vyapya vyavahara van. Ayam purusha. Therefore, this viveki purusha is also adhyasa, is having adhyasa. So, ataha vyavahara lingad viveki namapi dehadishu aham mama abhimanaha asti. This is aham mama abhimana is what? Dharmi adhyasa and dharma adhyasa. Asti iti anavadyam nirdushtam, there is no dosha. Nanu laukika vyavaharasya adhyasikatvya api jyotishtomadi vyavaharasya na adhyasa janyatvam. Purvapakshi has an objection. Okay, let's say in laukika vyavahara there is adhyasa. For viveki is also, you have shown Pashwadi Vishcha Visheshat. Okay. What about Shastriya Vyavahara? In Shastra, you cannot say there is Adhyasa. Vedika Vyavahara, how can you say there is Adhyasa there? So, Jyotishtomadi Vyavahara is Shruti statement which prods the person. It's a Vidhi. There, why do you say it is Adhyasa? There is no Adhyasa in such Vedika Vyavahara. So, Laukika Vyavahara se Adhyasikatvya api. Jyotishtomadi vyavaharasya na adhyasa janyatvam. Jyotishtomadi vyavahara is shruti siddha pramana siddha. In pramana siddha, shruti becomes a shabda pramana to get you to do jyotishtomadi yaga. There where do you have adhyasa? It is pramana janyatvam. So pramana janyatvam cannot be adhyasa janyatvam. You cannot have both go hand in hand. Na adhyasa janyatvam in the Vaidika case. Vaidika vyavahara kis. Tasya dehatirikta atmajnana purvakatva iti ashankya hetu mangi karoti shastriyatviti. Just because Shruti is saying it, you cannot say there is no adhyasa. If that is something that the Siddhanti responds with, no, I am showing jnana is there, says the purvapakshi. What is jnana? Dehatirikta atmajnana is there. If you are doing Jyotishtomadi Yaga, which is going to give Swarga Phala, Sadhya is Swarga there. Do you experience Swarga here and now? No. In this Janma, you won't experience Swarga. Then why do you do Jyotishtomadi Yaga? Shruti says that you will get Swarga Phala. So definitely there is Swarga Phala. Undoubtedly. Now, since there is Swargadi Phala, which is not going to be experienced in this Janma with this Deha, after this Deha drops off, then you will have experience of Swarga. The Yajamana will have experience of Swarga. Therefore, One who has the anubhava of swarga after giving up the body has to be different from the body. Body, mind, sense complex. So, dehadi vyatirikta atma is going to have swarga anubhava. That atma is necessarily to be understood as different from the dehadi. Otherwise, any person who has a basic understanding, basic buddhi, he will question, why will I do Jyotishtomadi Yaga even if Shruti says, why will I do it if I am not going to go? In the sense, this Deha is not going to go. He knows that I am not the Deha. That understanding is definitely there. This is what Purvapakshi makes an aropa. Deha tirikta atmajnana purvakatvad kasya vyavaharasya Jyotishtomadi vyavaharasya. If a person is doing Jyotishtomadi Yaga or anything which says that there is phala after the janma is over, dehadi is dissociated with, then that dissociated entity is you who is going to get this anubhava. This is atma, different from dehadi. That jnana is there. And it should precede the yaga, not after yaga. When yaga is prescribed and one takes to it, that time he knows. Thereby, hetu mangi karoti, shastriyetu iti. So, Bhagavan Bhashyakara first says, yes, I agree. That jnana has to be there. I have absolutely no arguments with you in this regard. So, in Moola, shastriyetu vyavahare, यद्यपि बुद्धिपूर्वकारी न अविदित्वा आत्मनः परलोक संबंधम अधिक्रियते तथापि. I accept, he says, सत्यम. This jnana is there. What you are saying in Jyotishtomadi Shastriya Vyavahara, Dehatirikta Atmajnana has to be there. That Atma is different from the body, mind, sense complex. That jnana has to be there. Definitely it has to be there. Satyam. However, Shastriye Jyotishtomadi Vyavaharetu Yadyapi Buddhi Purvakari. There is Buddhi preceding. What kind of understanding is preceding? Na Aviditva means not knowing. Atmana Paraloka Sambandham. Buddhi Purvakari Na Aviditva meaning not, Na and Nanj. Both are there. Na Aviditva meaning double negation. Meaning viditvayav. So, having known, not having known means having known. Although, there is buddhi preceding, that understanding that atma is different from the dehadi, body, mind, sense, complex, atmana paraloka sambandham. So, atma is going to have journey to paraloka, swarga, and there will be some sambandha whereby anubhava, bhoga will be there, swarga, bhoga. So this understanding, although it is there, tathapi, adhikriyate means adhikara, the person will not have adhikara unless one knows that, oh, atma is different, because phala has to be known. Why am I doing it? Because of swarga phala, which is ordained with this Jyotishtomadi Yaga, I am doing it for swarga phala, and that me is not going to be the same me that I consider with the body, mind, sense complex, it is different. So that entity is going to, that entity me, I am going to have swarganubhava. Tathapi na vedanta vidyam ashanayadyatitam apeta brahmakshatradi bhedam asamsaryatma tattvam adhikare apekshate. Although the vaidika karma adhikari needs to have this jnana to become the adhikari, to be the adhikari in swarga, swarga kama yajeta, swarga kama has to do Yaga Jyotishtomadi, and he knows that I am going to travel after the body drops off, so I am different from the body. But still he does not have Vedanta, meaning does not have, cannot be a statement of conclusion. One can say that it is not expected. Vedanta Jnana, Aikya Jnana is not expected there. In fact, not only expected, it is Viruddha also. Vedanta Vedyam, that Aupanishadam Purusham, Jnatum Ichhami, that पृच्छामि इन उपनिषद मंत्र इट इज सेड औपनिषदं पुरुषं पृच्छामि आई एम आस्किंग यू अबाउट दैट पुरुष आत्मा हू इज डिस्कस्ड इन द उपनिषद यू टेल मी दैट वन उपनिषद सेज उपनिषद इज अ डायलेक्टिक सो शिष्य इज आस्किंग द गुरु इन एन उपनिषद अबाउट एन उपनिषद पुरुष औपनिषद पुरुष नॉट एनी आत्मा विच इज डिस्कस्ड इन द पुराण in multiple ways including an upanishadic way but still I don't want that kind of a confusion I want to know that atma not the karmakandi's understanding of atma not the other darshanas darshanika's understanding of atma based on tarka ityadi or meditation or whatever I want to know that atma which is discussed in the upanishad which is vedanta vedyam that kind of knowledge is not expected for a karmakandi यजमान तथापि न वेदांत वेद्यम व्हाट इज दैट नाउ औपनिषद पुरुष वेदांत वेद्य पुरुष हु इज दैट आत्मा दैट आत्मा नॉलेज आत्मज्ञान इज नॉट नीडेड फॉर ज्योतिष तोमादि शास्त्रीय व्यवहार देन व्हाट इज दैट अशनायादि अतीतम वन दैट दैट आत्मा विच इज बियॉन्ड दी हंगर एंड थर्स्ट मीनिंग व्हाट भोगा इज नॉट पॉसिबल हाउ इज इट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दी Vaidika Karmakanda is understanding of Dehadi Vyatirikta Atma. That Atma is still a bhogi. Because Sukshma Sharira Sambandha is there. Without Sukshma Sharira, bhoga is not possible. The bhoga is in the Antakkarana. The prana has to be there. Without prana, travel is not possible. One will go to Anya Loka only if prana is there. In the Upanishad Jnana Moksha, Utkramana is not possible. There is no travel at all involved. The jnani's deha, not only the stula deha like the ajnani's deha is burnt, jnani's deha is burnt or buried if he is a sannyasi. But the sukshma sharira in the case of the ajnani has prana which makes the travel possible. Here, the entire sukshma sharira in the case of the jnani, brahmajnani, withers away into its fundamental components in karanas meaning bhautikas becomes reversed into bhutas panchamahabhutas here itself so there is no travel possible there is no janma possible because one who was taking janma is no longer there the one who was taking janma sukshma sharira what is janma sukshma sharira connection with stula sharira is janma one misunderstands that atma gets chaitanya brahmatma gets connected which is not true Brahmatma is all pervasive, one without a second. Ekameva Advitiyam Brahma has no connection with Sukshma Sharira alone, let alone the connection with Stula Sharira. So Janma is Bahuduram, impossible. But still, the difference, coming back to the difference between the Jnana, Atma Jnana of a Vaidika which is needed for Adhikara in that karma, Shastriya karma, versus the Vedanta Jnana. What is that Vedanta Jnana? Ashanadi Atitam. If one thinks that I am beyond Bhoga, meaning I cannot have any Bhoga, I am not a Bhogi, I am not a Bhokta, then why will one do Jyotishtomadi Yaga? Because Jyotishtomadi Yaga is for Swarga Bhoga. Swarga Bhoga will be possible for a Bhokta, whereas Vedanta Jnana means that one is not a Bhokta. Then why will one do something to become a Bhokta? You know, have bhoga. Bhoga is possible only if you have a bhokta. Bhogya, swarga. Bhogya is what? Bhoktum yogya. That which can be enjoyed. Experienced. And experience, we don't look for dukkha. We want, bhoga is translated as, not as experience, generally it is translated as enjoyment. Although, suffering is also bhoga. But in swarga, there is no suffering. Discounted, gauna. It is there but gauna. It is possible for a bhokta. I am not a bhokta. That jnana is not expected and it is also viruddha. We saw viruddha also. So Vedanta Vidyam Ashanayadi Atitam. Free from hunger and thirst kind of a bhoga. Apeta Brahma Kshatradi Bhedam. Kshatra Brahma here is Brahmana. Kshatra means Kshatriya. Adipadena. Vaidika adhikara, whoever has, meaning the trivarnika. So the third varna adhipadena vaishya. So brahmana can do particular kinds of yaga. Kshatriya can do rajasuya kind of a yaga. Both have phalas, both have adhikarityam, they are not interchangeable. What a brahmana can do, only brahmana can do. What a kshatriya can do, only kshatriya can do, only kshatriya should do, only then there is phala. So if brahmana says that I will do rajasuya yaga, he will not get phala, and there can be additionally papa also. Why? Because it is not ordained for him at all. Similarly, kshatriya starts doing brahmana karma, he will not get phala, he can get papa also. Now, how do you know brahmanattvam and kshatriyattvam? This is sharira dharma. There are many who say, you know, brahmana is based on the karma, there is differentiation. I'll not go into that discussion, but that is superficial, you know, trying to be politically correct. You need not be politically correct. In Shastra, in the pursuit of truth, you should not be, not need not be, should not be politically correct. This is my personal opinion. Why? Because you are, actually it is not Ruta. Being politically correct and being truthful cannot be possible at the same time in many cases. So you discount it for your audience. That may be possible publicly. In today's era, you cannot make such statements. It is may not be legally correct also. So people are careful. So that much you have to take it with a pinch of salt when even a jnani is talking about something or a public forum. But to be truthful to yourself, in your own journey, who is a brahmana? Shastra says that brahmana, even in Gita also, varna vyavastha is not created by human beings. It is there in the Vaidika system. One who says that anyone can become a brahmana or a kshatriya, that in the antakkarana the qualities are there is a different story. That does not make brahmana varna. Just because one has brahmana's qualities or one has kshatriya's qualities. Let's say you are born in a brahmana family, but you have kshatriya qualities, you can become a warrior. Like Dronacharya. Dronacharya was a brahmana, but still went on not only to teach, which is okay, teaching is his job, brahmana dharma. But he went to fight on the battle also, it is kshatra dharma. It is not brahmana dharma. But he did not give up teaching. So it's an additional role, which is, say, all right. But then he won't become a kshatriya due to that. That is why, in fact, if you study Gudartha Deepika or some parts, you know, where even Chakara of the Gita is commented upon, each and every word is commented upon. So Bhagavan Madhusudana Saraswati Acharya looks more into what is not seen generally in the verses. You see fillers to complete the meter, etc. There he makes a statement, just a detour there to make a point, as to when Duryodhana approaches the guru to say that you, he uses the word to address as a brahmana. So Dvijottama, he says Dvijottama. So when he is going to the Senapati and saying Dvijottama, at the beginning of the Gita itself, first chapter itself, so he says, hey Dvijottama, that Dvijottama is seen as Dvijanam Uttama, which is meaning, oh brahmana. It is actually an insult on the battlefield. It is not a praise. So people read as, oh, Dvija Uttama, Uttama has been said, so you are a brahmana, Uttama has been mentioned, so it means that there is a praise. It's not a praise. Looking into the mind of Duryodhana, reading additionally, he says that you are a brahmana on a battlefield is an insult. You are trying to become a kshatriya, you have no role to play here. This is what Duryodhana intends. Very nice reading into it. So to express the point that he was fighting, he taught fighting, he was fighting also. He was an excellent, you know, fighter also. that doesn't make the Senapati. So Dronacharya or Kripacharya, they don't become Kshatriya due to that. What does it show? It shows that just because you are good at something does not make you, and since you can do that, you cannot change your Varna. In fact, Puri Shankaracharya says that if that is the definition, that karma makes you a Brahmana or a Kshatriya, etc., then how many times he gives an example? Look at a woman, a traditional woman in the old economy setup or whatever you want to call it, in the cultural society of India, how many roles does a woman play? Throughout the day, what all she is doing, if you look at it, then she'll be going through all four Varnas at different times of the day. That will not change her Varna. She'll remain a Brahmana, she'll remain a Kshatriya ityadi. It will not change her Varna just because, you know, she is cleaning up or she is cooking or she is doing puja or anything. It won't change her Varna throughout the day. An example to drive home the point. So anyway, I thought that I'll not take a detour, but it's an important point I wanted to make, because all the Shastras, Bhashya, Tika, all of these, including all the Moola, talks about Varna as the Deha Dharma, Stula Deha Dharma. If it is an Antakkarana Dharma, the Antakkarana has been common throughout the life of any Jiva. So will it have the same Varna? Or will it be changing? In the Janma itself it can change, across Janma it can change. So it is not Antakkarana Dharma also. Whose Dharma is it? It is Stula Deha Dharma. One may not continue to be a Brahmana by, one may not hold on to that Brahmanattam or Kshatriyattam. For example, if Arjuna had given up the war on the battlefield, he would not have continued to be a Kshatriya, in the sense that in the next Janma, he won't have Kshatriya qualities to trigger something, some Prarabdha. Because he does not want to be Kshatriya in the next Janma, not in this Janma. In this Janma, he'll still be called a Kshatriya. That's why Bhagavan Krishna says in the Avachya, they'll talk about, people, if you run away from the battlefield being a Kshatriya, people will talk ill about you. Now, if everyone has an understanding that karma makes a person a Kshatriya or a Vaishya or a Brahmana, let him go and take sannyasa, beg or start a business. If Arjuna were to start a business, you know, start trading in gold or something, gold coins or whatever, you know, barter system, whatever, or agriculture, would he have become Vaishya? If he had become Vaishya, then why will people talk ill about him? Because if people have an understanding that this is what makes a person a Kshatriya or a Vaishya, now he is a Vaishya, he was a Kshatriya, he is no longer a Kshatriya. So why should you talk bad about it? Instead, it is better to look at each and every Varna have their own strengths based on the karma theory. They have taken those roles in particular Janmas, being born in particular Janmas. So whether Kalyanakrut or Akalyanakrut or Vaishya Buddhi is there, whatever it is there, it is a Deha Dharma and it is not the Atma Dharma. Thereby, Brahmakshatradi Bhedam. The Bheda between the Deha and me is not known to the person. In a sense, although it is known, that Dharmadhyasa is there. Because although one knows that I am different from the Sharira, but still I am a Brahmana. And that Brahmana has Adhikara in Jyotish Tomadi Yaga. Whereas I am Kshatriya who is different from the body, but Kshatriya Dharmatvam is still superimposed in that Atma which is free from the body. I am going to travel in the sense, I'll have Paraloka, Samsarga, Sambandha, and for that I am a Kshatriya. When will I get Swarga? Only if I do Rajasuya Yaga, not anything else, because I am a Kshatriya. Now this understanding is there along with the understanding that I am different from the body. So it is basically what? It is confusion. There is definite delusion that I am different from the body, but I am Brahmanattvam, Kshatriyattvam, ityadi. Mind-boggling. And that Brahmakshatradi Bhedam, Bheda is not necessary to be known for one to become an Adhikari in karma. In fact, if one knows the Bheda, then one will not become a Brahmana or a Kshatriya. One will not remain any of these and still continue to be that Atma which is Upanishad Vidya. Anyway, in Prarabdha, as long as Sharira is there, Sharira Dharma should be taken into account and one should behave according to Sharira Dharma. So, Unmatta Pishachavat a Jnani behaves, that is okay, that is Utkrushta Jnani, he does not know the Sharira at all. He has absolutely nothing to do with Sharira. That Utkrushta Jnani is different, but other Jnanis also, if you look at Mathadipatis and other Jnanis, they continue to do Vyavahara as though they are having a Sharira, have a fan following or whatever you want to call it, Shishya Varga. They have Dharma to follow, they have by setting an example. And also, if a sannyasi jnani was in Purvashrama Brahmana, then he is Shodashi Ityadi on drop of the Sharira also is as per the Shastra. It cannot be, he was a jnani, what Sharira? You can't just throw the body anywhere and say he is done with. Although Utkrushta Jnani does not care, but those who are following, they have to follow the same process. The Jnani Sharira should be taken care of because it is a Brahmana Sharira or a Kshatriya Sharira Ityadi. So the process has to be followed. So the Deha Dharma will be in the Deha. One superimposes on oneself for Laukika Vyavahara as a Jnani or without knowing for Vaidika Karma as an Ajnani. And therefore what? Asamsari Atma Jnana isn't there. I am a samsari, I need samsaranam, I need better samsara, I need better samsaranam, I need a better upadhi for better bhoga in swarga, in brahmaloka, ityadi. This is the understanding of the upasaka or the vaidika karma follower. Therefore, asamsari atma tattva adhikare, tattvam adhikare na apekshate. Tathapi na, this na will go with apekshate, na apekshate. It is not expected for the karmakandi who may have it. Who may be an Atmajnani is alright, but we are not talking about that kind of an entity. Purvapakshi does not intend that kind of an entity. He intends to talk about an Ajnani, not an Ajnani, a Vaidika Karmi who has Atma Jnana as Deha Bhinna, Dehadi Bhinna. So, although Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, I accept what you are saying, that Jnana definitely is expected, but Vedanta Vedya Jnana is not expected. What is the Hetu? Just making a statement won't work. So he says Anupayoga. It has no use here. Futile. What will you do with that knowledge? I am Asamsari Atma. How does it help him to do this? Vairika Yaga, which will give him Swarga. He wants Samsara. He does not want to be Asamsari. He is saying, I am a samsari. Who wants better samsara, better bhoga, better loka, better janma? So, I will do all of this karma which gives me all of these results, any of these results, one or more of those. What is the use of knowing that you are a samsari? It is contradictory. So, adhikara virodacha, also contradictory. If you know that you are different from the bhokta, meaning you are not bhokta, you are abhokta, then why will you struggle for any bhoga? It becomes a burden. Therefore, one will take sannyasa. Adhikara virodacha, jnani eva adhikara. The way Bhagavan Krishna tells Arjuna, what should I do? You tell me. Whether should I take to karma or to jnana? Over and over and over. Arjuna keeps on asking. But Bhagavan Krishna slips out. He does not give an answer. Idam ittham he does not say for a long time. Across chapters, Arjuna keeps on asking. Opening statement, again you tell me. He says you are praising jnana. You are praising karma. First you started praising karma and then you start praising jnana also. So what am I to do? I am confused, that's why I am taking your sharana. Now you are confusing me further. So he says ekam eva nishchitya. So you give me one definite answer as to which is better. There he says, for you, karma is better. Karma yoga is better. Karmani eva adhikaras te tava. For you, there is only adhikara in karma. Had you known yourself is different from the bhokta atma, you wouldn't be grieving. That shoka moha, which is the sutra bhuta shloka in Gita, 2.11 or 2.10, 2.11 perhaps. So you are not a pandita there. Others, you are talking like a pandita, but you are not a pandita. Ashochyan annasochastvam. Prajna vadansha bhashase. So there that you are talking this all this as if you are having this knowledge, but pandita na sochanti. Nanu sochanti. Na anu sochanti. The shoka moha that you have is possible only with the understanding that you are either the sharira or the having sharira dharmas, or even if you are deha vatirikta, you are still a samsari atma. You will have punya papa by killing your teachers, killing your bandhus, you will have killing your elders, you will have papa. This is thinking that atma is hanta and also hatam. The entire shloka, Gita is a commentary on that shloka itself. It is a sutra bhuta shloka. So that kind of understanding, because of which your Shastriya Adhikara is also there. You think that therefore you should stick to your Kshatra Dharma, Kshatriya Dharma. So Karmaniyeva Adhikaraste. Whereas a Jnani with that understanding that I am not the Sharira at all, the Atma does not have Janma, Mrityu, Atma is not a Karta Bhokta. Where is the connection at all? Where is the possibility of having Adhikara in Karma? So Jnaniyeva Adhikara. That kind of a person has adhikara. He has absolutely no adhikara in karma. So even if he continues, he has no phala. It is all karmadhyasa. It is a karmabhasa, abhasa. It is an abhasa of karma. Jnani's karma is a karmabhasa. It is not karma at all. It is not karma yoga also. It is karmabhasa. It appears like karma. It is not a karma. Why? He has no adhikara at all. There is no adhikara in karma. Like Brahmana doing Kshatriya karma or vice versa or whatever. There is no adhikara, there is going to be no phala. You make a sankalpa, whatever you want, but still there is no phala. Why? Because adhikarityam is lacking. Shastra talks about an adhikari, this kind of an adhikari will get this kind of phala. So swarga kamu ejet, one does not want swarga till it does yaga. Shastra says there is no swarga phala. He may do it, he will get chitta shuddhi. So in kamya karma also, without the kama, if one does kamya karma, by extension, that will also become chitta shuddhi karaka. So, prakcha tata bhuta atma vijnana pravartamanam shastram. We'll look at this, but then in tika. I just want to go through a little bit of vyakhyana before we stop. So, shastriyetu, then katham tarhi katham vaidika karmanaha adhyasa janyatva siddhi. Satyam, Bhagavan Bhashyakara said satyam. The entity who is doing the karma, the person who is doing the Vaidika karma, he has dehadirikta, the dehatirikta atmajnana. That much he has. So, katham tari Vaidika karmanaha adhyasa janyatva siddhihi. Then how can it be adhyasa janya? Vaidika karma, vyavahara, is a vyavahara, shastriya vyavahara. And yatra yatra vyavahara, adhyasa. Adhyasa tataratra adhyasa, therefore adhyasa janyatvam is there in vyavahara. This is your vyapti siddha artha. How can you have that siddhi here now? Because you are accepting Vaidika karma is with the dehatirikta atmajnana. Therefore adhyasa janyatva siddhi katham. I mean, how is adhyasa? It is an there is adhyasa there. There is no adhyasa. Iti ashangya kim tatra deha anya atmadhi matram apekshitam uta Atma Tattva Jnanam. There Bhagavan Bhashyakara is making two options. Yes, Atma Jnana is there. Dehatirikta Atma Jnana is there. But is it just knowing that you are different from Dehadi? Deha Anya Atma Dhi Matram Apekshitam. In that Vyavahara, what is expected in Shastri Vyavahara? Knowing that you are different from the Deha, only that much is necessary. Or Uta Atma Tattva Jnanam. Or the reality of Atma totally, in total Atma Tattva. Meaning, me being different from the body, Ekameva Advitiya and Brahma. Ekameva Advitiya Brahma Jnana is Atma Tattva Jnana. Is that expected there? It is not expected. So the Deha Anya Atma Dhi Matram is expected. Adye, meaning in the earlier case, where if the Purvapakshi says Atmajnana necessary for Vaidika karma is knowing yourself as merely knowing yourself is different from the body. Adye tasya adhyasa abadakatvat. That does not have anything to do with to take away adhyasa. Adhyasa can still be there. In fact, adhyasa is there. So tasya, what is expected there, that does not take away anything from adhyasa also continuing. Adhyasa, tasya adhyasa abadakatvat. It is not a badaka for adhyasa. It will not counter adhyasa. It will continue in sync happily with adhyasa. That understanding that, oh, I am different from the body, but I am samsari atma, I am karta bhokta atma, I am that karta who has adhikara in jyotishtoma adi yaga, and I am bhokta, I will have bhoga adhikara, I will get bhoga as a phala in swarga. So swarga prapti is possible. So I am karta bhokta atma different from the sharira. That much jnana is needed, which is adhyasa. In Vedanta perspective, that is adhyasa, that is also adhyasa. Therefore, adhyasa janyatvam is there, tasya, adhya tasya, adhyasa, abadakatvat, tat siddhi, meaning adhyasa siddhi, adhyasa is still established. Iti aha tathapi iti. So we saw that in the mula tathapi. Na dvitiya ityaha. But if you say, atma tattva jnana, aham brahmasmi jnana is expected for laukika, for vaidika vyavahara, that is not true. Na dvitiya ityaha, na vedanta iti. So vedanta vedya atma need not be known there. That is not expected at all. Why? So there, Kshutpipasa, the Atitam has been mentioned. So Kshutpipasa, the Grastaha, Jati Visheshavan, Aham, Samsariti, Jnanam, Karmani Apekshitam. What is necessary in the karma? Knowing that I am a bhokta. Kshutpipasa, the Grastaha, I have hunger, I have thirst, I have these kind of afflictions I take away by eating food, I take away my hunger by eating food, I take away my thirst by drinking water, etc. Similarly, I will have swarga ananda anubhava because I am a bhokta. And jati visheshavan, how will I get swarga? If I am a brahmana, by jyotishtomadi, by, if I am a kshatriya, then by rajasuyadi. So jati visheshavan aham. I have jati which is actually deha dharma. So jati visheshavan aham samsari, I am a samsari, I will go to another loka and have this anubhava, that jnanam karmani apekshitam. It is expected in karma, nothing else. Na tad viparita atma tattva jnanam. Opposed to that is this jnana as to what? I am not shutpipasa adhigrasta, I am not bhokta, I am abhokta. Sorry, there is some noise in the background. So I am abhokta, which is opposed to jnana, that I am bhokta, for a necessary for a karmi. Jati visheshavan, I am a brahmana, I am a kshatriya, this jnana is needed for brahmana karma or kshatriya karma ityadi. But I am not a brahmana, I am not a kshatriya, I am not a vaishya, I am not a shudra, I am not a manushya, I am not definitely not a pum or a stri. I am not further samsari also. So, asamsari. This is the jnana for a one who has tattva jnana. So, tadviparita atma tattva jnanam. Atma tattva jnana is different from this. It is opposite, in fact, to what is expected in the Vaidika karma. Anupayogat pravritti badhacha ityartha. Anupayogat because it is not going to be useful for pravritti in karma. If you tell someone, oh, you are abhokta, but please do this karma for sarga bhoga. He'll say, what is this? Has absolutely, why are you making such useless statements? If I am a abhokta, then why will I do anything for sarga bhoga? I should be really stupid to do this yaga for bhoga. If I do this yaga, it's all right, not for bhoga. But to do this yaga for bhoga, while knowing you are telling me that I am abhokta, I have to be really stupid. Shastriya karmana adhyasa janyatvam nigamayati. And further, he concludes adhyasa in shastriya vyavahara also. So, since it's a conclusion, let's have a look at that also. I'll take a few more minutes. So then prakcha tatha bhuta atma vijnana pravartamanam shastram avidyavad vishyattam na ati vartate. Therefore the conclusion is same as the nigamanam, is same as the pratijna. Pratijna has been made saying that all these pramanas, pratyakshadini shastrani cha pramanani, pramanani shastrani cha, pratyakshadini pramanani shastrani cha avidyavad vishyani, has been mentioned, it has established. Now pratyakshadi have been accepted as avidyavad vishya, meaning they are operate in a avidyavan purusha, meaning adhyasa is there in that purusha. Then the differentiation was made between an ajnani, meaning a viveki and aviveki. But there is no differentiation. Adhyasa is common to both. The only difference is that if you take brahmajnani, then adhyasa is badhita anuvritti. Adhyasa has badhita anuvritti. Then the comparison was made, oh, what about laukika versus shastriya? In laukika, let there be adhyasa for anyone, but let it not be for shastriya vyavahara. Let's not accept adhyasa in shastriya vyavahara case. That has also been shown. Therefore, what? Prakcha tathabhuta atmavidnya. Tathabhuta is samsari kshutpipasadi grasta brahmana kshatra dharmavan, jatiman. That kind of a entity I am. This understanding is there. That is the atmavidnyana, which is deha vetirikta. Who will have traveled, therefore, samsari atma. That atma vijnanat pravartamanam shastram. The shastra pravutti is possible only with this jnana. Therefore, avidyad vishyattvam na ati vartate. There is no dosha there. There is no flaw at all, because this is expected in fact. Adhyasa is expected in shastriya vyavahara. So you cannot say there is no adhyasa. In shastriya vyavahara also adhyasa is actually expected. Only then the ordainment is there. It is only for a karta. The vidhi ling will apply only as a vidhi for a karta, bhukta by extension. Then the prakcha is closed in the nigamana, is closed in the tika also, vyakhyana also, by saying adhyase, so there is no commentary there. Then adhyase agamam pramanayati, we will look at this in the next part. यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गत्वप्यरी सहोदराप महत्पदं तमहं आशु हरिं परमाश्रय जनकजां कमलं च सुखाकृतिं तत्सत्। नमस्ते।
नमस्ते। थैंक यू।